If you and your students are already utilizing the Office 365 environment, or if you're interested in utilizing some of the deeper tools that are available in Microsoft Teams, then Teams is a great option for you to utilize as part of your virtual student hours. In this video, I will show you how you can use Microsoft Teams in order to allow students to connect with you during those virtual student hours. So to start things off, make sure that you go to teams.microsoft.com. If you're already logged into MyCVTC, then it should log you in automatically to your CVTC instance of Microsoft Teams. Now, there's a lot of options available in here, and I would say that if you don't already know how to use Microsoft Teams, it might be a good idea for you to line up a training with us in CPD, just so that we can help orient you in how to get around in this environment. But if we want to set up virtual student hours, then my suggestion would be to go into the Teams area. So you can click on the Teams tab here on the left-hand side. And this will show you all the teams that you currently belong to. In the upper right-hand corner, we can click on Join or Create a Team. Then I'll click this button right here, Create Team. And it'll give you a few different options of what type of team that you want to make. I would suggest for student virtual hours that we just select the other category. So I'll click other, and then I'll give my team a name. And then I'll hit next. Once my team is created, it'll ask me if I want to add members to it. For now, we don't need to do that, so I'm just going to click on skip. Now my team has been created, and it has this default channel in my team called General. Now this is what we can use to get the shareable link for our video conferences. So you'll see that down below in this chat area, there's a number of buttons available, and one of the buttons is the Meet Now button. So if you click on that button, it's going to start a new video conference. I'll click on Meet Now, and now my video conference is live. Over on the right-hand side, you'll see this panel of who's currently in the meeting, and you'll see that this little copy joining info button right here. This is what gives us the shareable link. So if I click on that link, I've copied the shareable link, and now I can go back over to my Canvas course and access my homepage to paste it in. I'll edit my homepage. You'll see here that I've already provided some text for my learners in how to connect with me. I'll go down here and just go down a line, and I will right-click and paste. And that pastes in some pre-made links that were provided from Microsoft Teams. And so basically what I would want to do is go back and change some of this text so that these links are appropriate to what I'm communicating to my students. But then I'll click on Save. And now my students will be able to click on those links to access the virtual conference to connect in with me. Now, my advice would be that once you do this and you save that link to your course homepage, you can go ahead and close out of Microsoft Teams. And then in the future, when you want to hold your virtual student hours, you don't really need to go to Microsoft Teams to do that. Instead, I would recommend that you just go to your course homepage and click the same link that your students would click. That will jump you straight into that particular video conference, and you can reuse that conference over and over to connect in with your students. A few other things to just point out about Microsoft Teams. If I go back here, you'll see that there are some controls here on the bottom. I can hide my camera with this button. I can hide my, I can mute my microphone rather. I can share my screen, and students can also share their screens. There's some more options that are available in here to check things like my microphone, my speakers, and my webcam. I can hang up the call right here. And there's a number of other options available. Like I said, if you're interested in using Microsoft Teams, I would highly encourage that you reach out to CPD and schedule a training, because it is a very robust tool that has a lot of stuff available in it. If you're interested in using Microsoft Teams for virtual student hours, then I hope this was helpful. Make sure to check out our other video on Google Meet if you're curious about using that platform instead. And as always, reach out to CPD if you have any questions. Thanks for watching.